You found it. Your home for the best content on your favorite team, the Fighting Tigers of LSU. Do us a favor. Subscribe to the channel. Leave your comments below. Be sure to smash that like button. One of the really interesting dynamics, in my opinion, of this game with LSU and Florida State is the familiarity. LSU and Florida State, not so much. They've played 9 times in history. Florida State leads the series 7-2. Of course, LSU's maybe most famous win over Florida State came back in 1982 when LSU blew out Florida State and fans pelted the field with oranges, and LSU went on to the Orange Bowl that year in 1982. But by and large, when LSU was struggling in the 80s and 90s is when these two teams played more frequently. And Florida State, of course, was an emerging power in college football and had their way. I can remember vividly as a kid watching the 1991 game where LSU led early. They led 10. Todd Kinchin hit. They had a big play to Todd Kinchin early in that ball game. Tigers got a turnover into a field goal. LSU led 10-0, and that didn't really go well after that. But there's a different feel. Again, LSU and Florida State, maybe not great history, certainly not recent history. I haven't played in 30 years, but Brian Kelly and Florida State have a lot of history. These two teams opened up against each other a year ago. Brian Kelly brought his last Notre Dame team into Florida State for a week 1 game that went to overtime. Notre Dame had a big lead, blew it. Florida State rallied, tied it, sent it to overtime, where Notre Dame ultimately won it. But Brian Kelly played against Mike Norvell each of the last 2 years. He's played Florida State 3 of the last 4 seasons. So he knows the players, the personnel, much of the coaching staff, certainly Mike Norvell well, and Norvell knows Kelly also. But here was Kelly today talking about leading his first LSU team to his first game as head coach of the Tigers.
For me, you know, taking an LSU football team into its first week of preparation for a game against a, you know, really good Florida State team is you know, one that I think there's, you know, around the office, there's a heightened sense of excitement. Everybody is anticipating a great week. And, you know, our preparation has been one where, you know, certainly you want to see the culmination of your team come together and play outstanding football.
One of the things, T-Bob talked about this last week on Scone and T. And we kind of got into the conversation of, would you rather start with a tune-up game, or would you rather start with a really good opponent? There's two different schools of thought. Of course, if you're Florida State, you got the glorified dress rehearsal against Duquesne, which gets you kind of ready for this against LSU. The flip side of it is, and if you remember, look, LSU has done this quite often now, where they've opened up with big-time opponents. I mean, you can go back to, really, if you want to think about it, 2007 opened up on the road on a Thursday night against Mississippi State. It was a conference game. 2008, they opened up against Appalachian State. But then 2009, they opened up against Washington in Seattle. 2010, opened up in Atlanta against North Carolina. 2011, opened up in Dallas or Arlington against Oregon. That was a top 5 matchup. I mean, this has become a more regular thing for LSU to have the big marquee name brand opponent in the neutral site game or whatever it is to open up. Last year, of course, it was UCLA in the Rose Bowl. And the point that T-Bob made, and again, I would defer. I've never been in a locker room to know. I can ask these guys what their opinion is. But he said, I liked playing the big opponent. It kept you focused all throughout the offseason because you knew you had a big-time opponent, and it felt like every rep, every practice, everything mattered because of what was waiting for you week 1. Certainly that was the case when they played Oregon in 2011 and a lot of these other games, and I think is the case for this team as well. New era, new coach, big opponent, it all matters. Play number 13, Muse, if you would. Brian Kelly was asked about Florida State getting to play the tune-up game, though. And I thought his answer, he was pretty candid with his answer here.
I think there's some pluses and minuses there. Like I said, I think we've got the advantages that they don't have any film on us. You've got a new head coach. You've got new coordinators. You know, that in itself, there's the uncertainty of them knowing what to expect. You know, so there is a bit of a trade-off there.
So new coach, new coordinators, all that stuff. But specifically, I think the advantage for LSU is in Matt House. Here's what I mean. Florida State knows. Brian Kelly's an offensive coach. Florida State knows what Brian Kelly and Mike Denbrock want to do. You can go look at Cincinnati a year ago. Different players, to be sure, but alignment, you know what they are. You can go look at Brian Kelly's offenses. You played against them each of the last 2 years. You know what they are offensively. The big unknown that, in my opinion, is a benefit to LSU is Matt House. Matt House wasn't a coordinator in Kansas City. He hasn't been a coordinator since he was at Kentucky. Now, that was in the SEC. But if you're Florida State, you really don't know what Matt House's defense is going to look like. And Mike Norvell talked about that when he met with the media.
A little bit of unknown of exactly what the presentation of what they're going to do schematically. You know, defense coordinator Coach House, you know, has been, you know, in NFL for the last few years. You know, we've looked at, you know, everything through this offseason, whether it's going back to Kentucky film from 18-19, you know, being able to go watch Kansas City, watching the Chiefs. I mean, trying to get a, you know, just as much, you know, broad perspective of, you know, what we could potentially see, but also in the fact of, you know, studying the personnel of guys that were there and then guys that came from other places.
You see how much Florida State has to work on with LSU? They got to go look at Oklahoma State film to look at Jarek Bernard-Converse. They got to go look at ULL film to look at Mekhi Gardner. They got to go look at McNeese film to look at Colby Richardson. They got to go look at Missouri film to look at Mekhi Wingo. They got to go look at Kentucky film from 2018 to try to have an idea of what Matt House is going to do as far as presentation. They got to look at Kansas City Chiefs film. You see the challenge? Like, that really is the challenge. And when you look at where LSU's inherent advantage lies in this matchup, by the way, it's the same for Florida State, where their matchup is. We'll get to that. The advantage for LSU is the LSU defensive line against that Florida State offensive front. I think Florida State has three really good running backs, y'all. One of the biggest takeaways watching that game Saturday against Duquesne, I get it, it's Duquesne, I get it. But fast is fast, hard to bring down is hard to bring down, power, speed, strength, all that. And that was on display with all three of those guys. And when you can rotate three competent running backs, you have fresh legs running at a defense that can wear down throughout a game. Like, that's a reality. But LSU's defensive front is an advantage over that Florida State offensive line. And now if Matt House is able to bring pressure and looks and disguises and blitzes and things that they don't know how it's coming or how it looks, there's a lot of modifying on the fly in game for Florida State. I'm telling you, that's the thing. And it was something that when I was asking a lot of coaches over the weekend about which advantage would you rather, playing the game or having the film to scout the team that played? And routinely, the answer that came back was Matt House. It's, they don't know what he's going to do. And as a coach, that's unsettling because you want to feel like you're going in with a plan. You want as much information as possible to put together your plan. And Florida State don't have that. Now, the flip side is also true. Florida State's offensive front is really good. And LSU's offensive line is, I think they have really good players, a good starting five. But you got dudes in new positions. You got a new quarterback working on new cadence, a center that's never snapped the ball, a freshman left tackle. I mean, there's a lot of ifs. So in Tallahassee, they're having this conversation today as well, and they're right. But the other part of that, too, is the Matt House dynamic of this. I asked Brian Kelly about facing Florida State a year ago, and if going through game prep for Mike Norvell a year ago helps him this week going through game prep for Florida State this year.
I mean, there's a new offensive and defensive coordinator for me. You know, it's a whole new team. I don't know that it really helps as much as I can give and lend a little bit more, you know, to our coordinators. I meet with our coordinators, you know, daily, so I can give them a little bit of insight in terms of, you know, what they're about and how they play the game and what they're looking to do on offense and defense. But that's about it. Other than that, this is a whole new operation for us relative to coordinators and the football team in itself.
You look for little small edges. And in a game where the line is around a field goal, some spots have it at 2.5 right now, LSU 2.5. Any little advantage here or there could be the difference in what is likely going to be a very close ball game. So you look for those, and each team has a little something to lean on after week 0. Florida State had the benefit of working out the kinks. LSU has the benefit of looking at game film to see how they might attack this team or defend this team. Ultimately, though, they'll go play it on Sunday. We'll get all these answers. Hey, thanks so much for watching. Please leave your comments. I love to interact. And be sure to hit the red subscribe button below.